afternoon, good morning, good evening. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Counseling with Juliet. I appreciate you out there, as many of you that have subscribed and leaving your comment. I really appreciate you. And if you are yet to subscribe, you're just watching me or seeing me for the first time, please, I will beg you to subscribe into this channel and press also the notification button, so that whenever I upload the new videos, you'll be the first person to be notified. How are you doing? This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I love rejoicing. I hope you're out there enjoying yourself. Please do not let anything to bring sadness to your hearts. The devil is always there to cause anger. Please just let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice forevermore. Hallelujah. I have a topic before me that says, I'm talking about communication. Communication, a great key in marriage. Communication is a great key in marriage. In case you are out there watching me, you don't know, I want to tell you that today, communication is a great key in marriage. A lot of people have lost it because there is no communication. That is why we always advise you, marry your friend. Don't marry a stranger. Because if you are with a stranger, you can't communicate. You just be an acquaintance. Maybe you greet and that is all. But if you are married to your friend, you will communicate. And communication strengthens marriage. Communication strengthens marriage. And whenever you communicate with your spouse, it means you cannot hide anything from your spouse. You are not ashamed to bring anything before your spouse in the table of communication. That is why when God created Adam and Eve, they were naked and they were not ashamed. That is what the book of Genesis told us. Because you know why? He has already made them male and female. They were together as one and one flesh. They were not ashamed of anything. Not until when they committed sin that they knew that, it's as if we are naked and they were not ashamed. Communication is not there. You will be ashamed to talk. You will be passing through a lot of things. You can't share it with your husband. You can't share it with your wife. And that is what is killing a lot of women today. A lot of women, they are depressed in their home. Because why? No communication. They lack communication. They're married to a total stranger. Or rather, they are not open. The Bible says two of you will not become one. Meaning when you are one, you cannot hide anything from your spouse. You need to be open to your spouse. Let me tell you, do you know the basic factor that makes Eve to fall in the Garden of Eden? Because why? The Bible makes us understand that Jesus always comes at the cool of the evening to communicate with them, to interact, to have fellowship with them. I don't know where Adam went to that day. I don't know. If you know, please tell me. I don't know. That made Eve, she was not so lonely. She was so lonely that she could give ear to the devil to speak to her. That is what is happening in a lot of marriages today. When you find out that there is no communication, lack of communication, before you know, evil begin to manifest. They will begin to hear from their friends. And let me tell you, none of your friends there is out there to make your marriage better. It is you that need to put hard work in your marriage. If it will go in any good level, it depends on you. Because there's no communication, lack of communication will not make the woman to carry the hope outside. It will not be taking decision for what her friends discuss with her. Because why? He lack communication with the husband. He cannot sit the husband down or the wife down and say, "My honey, this thing that you did, I don't like it." And do you know what communication has caused? It has caused a lot of divorce today in our society. Because why? The moment you keep on heaping anger, heaping things in your heart that you are supposed to talk over, before you know, it will come to an elastic point that you can't take it anymore. And it has caused breakage in many marriages. If you are there looking at me, I'm talking to you. Please try to communicate with your spouse. No matter what you are passing through, try to communicate with your spouse. Let me tell you, there is no better person that you can tell yourself to. Because the Bible said, you two of you have become one flesh. So if your spouse go out and bring you out, it's not only disgracing you, it's also disgracing yourself because you are one. So I don't see anything there. If you are a woman, you know that you are passing through a lot of things that is causing anger or causing problem in your heart. You are not settled. Call your husband. You can wait and call him at the cool of the evening when you know that he's in a happy mood or she's in a happy mood. Because at times, a lot of people don't even know the best way to pass communication. They don't know the best way. They can go and want to talk to their spouse in the wrong time, and before you know, instead of it to bring peace, it will result to massive problem. Because why? They don't know the best time to talk to their spouse. So that is why you need understanding in your marriage. So when the time is, you call your spouse at the best time, you talk it over. Talk about your sex life. It is not a sin. It is what God has given to you in that marriage to replenish, to make sure that you're going well in your home. In the Christendom, they have so published sex so much to the world because you know why? Devil has taken hold of it. The way he's using it. So whenever you see it being spoken of in the public, people think, you are not holy. But it is part of what God created, and he said it was all good. So if you are there, you know that there's something that is bothering you. It might be a particular manner, a particular way, things that you are seeing in the marriage that is not giving you joy. Sit down with your spouse and talk it over. And apart from that, always gist with your spouse. Communicate, talk. You know, we women, we like talking. Some people say, some women, I'm a woman, I don't like. No, there's no woman that does not like talking. Except that woman has not seen a particular topic to talk about. If you have something to talk about, you say it. Call your husband, draw his attention. And if you are married to that kind of a spouse that does not know how to talk, teach him. Teach her. Engage them in gist. Talk about yourselves. Talk about God. Talk about, there are a lot of stories in the Bible. Sit down with your spouse. Study, communicate, talk. Talk about your children. Talk about your home. Talk about what you foreseen your marriage to become in the next 5-10 years if Jesus tarries. Talk about a lot of things that will bring joy. Have time for yourself so that you will be close to your spouse. I feel for a lot of women out there, they will say, my best friend. Who is your best friend? Your husband is your best friend. Your wife is your best friend. Your children, they might not even be your best friend. Let me tell you why. Because those children that you have, they will get married and go. It will not be left with you and your spouse. So it should be your best friend. So coming to say, my best friend, making best friend outside, and meanwhile you are at home, you don't have any good rapport, communication with your spouse, is a big mistake. It's an error. Because that is the only person that can stand by you. Those people that you feel that you are your best friend, let me tell you, it is only when you will only know your friends when you're in trouble. When everything is good, everybody will be your friend. But when trouble comes, you will know who will stand by you. So please, I want you to build your communication system at home. Build it well. Build it well. Look at your spouse. Tell your children, you are looking good. You are looking wonderful. Talk about things that you know. As far as you don't talk about people. And even if you talk about people, you don't talk about them bad. Then call your spouse and begin to make that communication solid. It will keep your home. It will keep your home. He was so isolated. I think so. That is why the devil was able to get her. As the devil got her, he also transferred to the husband. You see, he wasn't communicating good thing to Adam. If he was a woman that was wise, as far as that thing, the devil come, he will tell the serpent, please wait, let me first of all go and ask my husband whether we should take the apple or not. Eve was not wise. That was why when the serpent just came and said, take from the apple and eat, he just accepted it. One. It shows that she was not submissive to Adam. A submissive wife, he would go home and say, please, you know, I'm not the one that married myself. Somebody married me and kept me. Don't let me ask from him. I believe if Eve had gone to ask Adam, maybe Adam would have said, no, God said we should not eat from this fruit. But Eve was trying to do the boss, which she was not. And that was what landed them in trouble. So please, communication is very vital in marriage. I'm using this avenue to talk to as many women that are depressed there, as many women that are passing through one problem. They don't know who to speak with. Please communicate. Try to talk to your spouse. Because we women, we suffer these things a lot. Communicate with your spouse, no matter what. Even if you think that he's not hearing you, she's not hearing you, please. There is nobody that is stronger than God. The heart of a man is in the hands of God. Commit that person to the hands of God. And let God give him the heart of flesh so that you can be able to communicate and pass that message to them. But meanwhile, we advise you, please don't communicate wrong thing to your spouse. Don't lead them in the wrong way. Because if you do it, God will ask you in the last day. A lot of people don't know that their marriage is an institution that God wants you to establish and cater for very well. Because if it goes wrong, God will ask you. So if you are that woman that used to communicate evil to your husband, that used to swear people for your husband, you don't see anything good in anybody, so therefore you don't want your husband to see anything good in them or your wife to see anything good, please change and communicate good things to your husband and your wife. I believe this word has blessed you that is watching me. Please share. Somebody out there might benefit from it. I don't know. Please just share. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so by subscribing. God will bless you. And if you have any comment, any message, anything that you want us to talk about, that is why there is counseling for Juliet. I am there. By the help of God, we will sort it out. Thank you and have a wonderful day. I see you next time. Bye.